This video will show you how to set up a JWT authentication in Qlik Sense. First, we have to set a virtual proxy. Click the Create New button at the bottom. In the description field, add a name for the virtual proxy. Then insert a prefix. In this case, we insert JWT. We will also append JWT to the session cookie header name to make it unique. Click Add New Server Node and select a server node. Then, from the authentication method drop-down menu, we select JWT. JWT requires a key pair to sign and verify tokens. Identity providers sign tokens with a private key, whereas service providers verify tokens with the public key. Qlik Sense as a service provider needs the public key to verify the token. For demonstration purposes, we are going to use the default auto-generated keys. The default location for certificates is c:\program_data\qlik\sense\repository\.localcertificates. In this example, we will copy the server certificate and paste it here. In the JWT attribute for user ID field, insert the attribute used for JWT authentication. Here we use username. In the JWT attribute for user directory field, insert the attribute for the user directory. You can add more attributes if needed. When done, click Apply and then click OK to confirm. Now that we've created a virtual proxy, we have to attach it to a proxy. In this case, we select the central proxy. Under Associated Items, we select Virtual Proxies. Then we click the Add button to link the virtual proxy we just created. We can't check in Qlik Sense as this does not allow us to access on this virtual proxy since we are not passing the bearer token. So to check if this configuration works, we are going to open jwt.io and go to the debugging section. Here we are going to create a JWT token. First, from the drop-down menu, select the algorithm. Qlik Sense supports RS-256, RS-384, and 5RS-12 algorithms. In payload, you can pass any attribute you want, but we at least have to add the username and user directory attributes we defined for our virtual proxy in Qlik Sense. Identity providers sign tokens using the private key. JWT.io requires both keys for the debugger to generate the token. In this example, we are going to use server.pem and server_key.pem. Once you've copied and pasted the certificates, you have the token that you can paste in a header request. In this case, we are going to use a Google Chrome extension called Modify Header that allows you to replace the value of the header. We can add a new header variable named authentication and pass as value bearer followed by the token. When we turn on the extension, this will inject the header variable, in this case, the JWT authentication. Now, if we refresh the Qlik Sense hub server, we can access the hub with the correct user. Qlik, the user that we've added in JWT. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.